When you gauge everything with not only them drafting Lamar, they liked him. They originally had the 16th pick. They liked him at 16. They were able to get out of that selection and still get him in the first round. And you have the type of staff that they do. Marty Morningwig, the offensive coordinator. We know that his experience with Kaepernick and in San Francisco, that's going to play a role. The quarterback coach also has experience with Colin Kaepernick. And they have told him that they're going to install a certain package for Lamar. So anytime you have the coaching staff, they're going to augment the offense or defense, you know that player is getting ready to play. When the defensive coordinator, offense coordinator, they come into a meeting and say, listen, we have this package for this player. He's that kind of special. You know as a player on that unit that you're going to see this player. So then if they have a package, it's not that big of a step to give him the full game plan. So I expect Lamar Jackson to see significant action and potentially start this year for the Baltimore
Ravens. And how they acquired him. Not only a first-round pick. Not only a first-round pick that they traded back into the first round to get, but Ozzie Newsome's final first-round pick ever. I think that really matters. You said that as an aside the other day. This is.
I don't think it matters that he plays quarterback. I think that the player for the
that's what I mean.
Given their position, he would have to love the player.
That's what I think it matters that this is the guy that Ozzie Newsome said, I'm using my final first-round pick on. Ozzie Newsome, who arguably has had a Hall of Fame front office career with the Baltimore Ravens and what he's done and being the architect of a couple Super Bowls there, what he saw in Lamar, and let's be totally candid here, what they've seen in Joe Flacco over the last 5 years. Like Flacco's quarterback rating over the last 4 years, 91 to 83, stayed at 83, last year down to 80. His touchdowns to interceptions last year, 18 to 13. His yards per attempt, man, I had to double check this. I didn't think this was accurate. 5.7 yards per attempt when anything under 7.1 is below average. I mean, that's taking deep. He's a guy, the one thing of Flacco that had been elite was his ability to throw deep. Like, that is dinking and dunking to the extreme. That's Brandon Whedon-level dinking and dunking. So, like, the Ravens know they need to get better at that position.
They have to get better, and that's Lamar. He's there, and he's going to play. I mean, he's going to play. He's going to get significant action. And Joe Flacco is doing the smart thing. He's in the last year of his contract. Last year, he's got guaranteed money. So all the signs, not only because of who they drafted, but the way his contract is situated. We always say in the locker room, look at the contracts, and you can see who's going to play. And most of the time, that's true to form.
So is all this talk of him maybe splitting time, playing a somewhat of a different position or a different type of the quarterback role, is that all done?
Well, I don't think it was about him playing a different position. Not with the Ravens. It was about them putting him in different packages as a quarterback.
Yeah, and as a first initial, the combine doing the interviews, teams have not fessed up and come forward and said, we were a team that was interested in him at playing wide receiver. Okay. Also, you have to listen to the prospect. The prospect said he can't catch. He has no interest in playing wide receiver, not because he has no interest in trying to help the team, because he's not a good wide receiver.
Also, this is a place where the NFL history matters here. Do you know the last quarterback taken in the first round that did not start at least one game their rookie year? It was Aaron Rodgers. Think about that. Every single first-round quarterback since Aaron Rodgers has found the field as a starter at some point in their rookie season. Guys do not get redshirt years anymore. Rodgers got a couple. I remember famously Steve McNair got a couple when the Houston Oilers drafted him. Nobody, we heard 2 years ago, Jared Goff, there's no chance he's playing. We're not going to play Jared Goff. They put him into the lineup. DeShone Kizer last year, I know he's second rounder. He's not ready. There's no chance he's playing. He found his way into the lineup immediately. They don't spend first round picks on guys to not have them play. It's probably one of the reasons the Giants didn't take a quarterback at number two, because they're not going to redshirt a guy. They're not going to waste one of the years at the cheap contract. They're not going to waste that valuable of a pick to have a guy not play for you.
And you talk about the history of Baltimore, Ozzie Newsome, what he's trying to do there. Let's not forget Cleveland's starting quarterback right now, Tyrod Taylor. How did he cut his teeth in the league? 4 years in Baltimore, learning his craft because they believed in him and believed he could be a starter. So when they believed in Tyrod, they also believed that a quarterback like Tyrod could play effectively in the NFL. Now, Lamar is taller, is faster, and a better thrower than Tyrod will ever be as a quarterback.
And I'm sorry to interrupt you. I apologize. We also have to remember the Flacco situation pre-Super Bowl. Why was Flacco able to get that monster deal after they won the Super Bowl? Because the Ravens hadn't extended him.
Well, no, he turned down the contract. He bet on himself.
Right, he bet on, right, correct. They hadn't agreed to a contract extension. So whatever the extension offer was, Flacco said, I can do better. And he ended up going on an all-time run in those playoffs, thing, 11 touchdowns, no interceptions. The reason I bring it up is this. The Ravens had been shaky about how much we really want to commit to Joe Flacco, and then he won him a Super Bowl, and then he got no choice. And from the moment he won the Super Bowl until right now, it doesn't matter what they want to do at quarterback. He's one of the biggest cap hits in the league. He got a giant quarterback contract before a lot of guys were getting giant quarterback contracts. CeCe's point of next year is the first year they can get off that contract. It makes sense that next year will be the first year they have a quarterback waiting in the wings.
It should be mentioned, too, that they haven't been good on the field since they lost their leader in Ray Lewis. So not only do they need to look at a quarterback, they need to look at new leadership. And I believe Lamar Jackson brings that leadership.
That's a good point. All right, coming up, what's next for the Raptors after being swept by the Cavs again? Next on First Things First.